Welcome to the Heavy Spoilers Show. I'm your host, Paul, aka the guy who wants to let them fight on the big screen, not on a streaming service, but apparently that's what's going to be happening. Now, this report comes from The Hollywood Reporter, who've said that Godzilla vs. Kong is likely the latest tentpole to go to a streaming service. Before we get into it, if this is your first time at the channel, then please hit that subscribe button, as we do videos like this every day, and you know, you'll probably love it, even if you hate the English accent. We're giving away 3 copies of the Marvel Phase 2 box set to 3 of our subscribers, but I'll talk about that at the end of the video rather than rambling on about it here because you don't care. Now, Netflix have apparently made a bid of more than $200 million in order to secure Godzilla vs. Kong for their streaming service. We also heard that they were doing something similar with No Time to Die. And due to all the delays that this film has gone through, I think they're just throwing a hit out here and hoping that, you know, Warner Brothers knock it back to them. Is that a baseball metaphor? Not sure, but you know what I mean. Now, The Hollywood Reporter says that knowledgeable sources tell them Netflix has made this offer for the film, whilst Warner Media has actually blocked the deal because they're preparing it for their own streaming service, HBO Max. Legendary has declined to comment, but a Warner Brothers spokesperson has come forward and said, "We plan to release Godzilla vs. Kong theatrically next year as scheduled." Now, I think this is a movie that needs to be seen on the big screen. You know, it's Godzilla, it's Kong. They're having a fight. Releasing that to a streaming service, in my opinion, would be really underplaying the movie. And you know what? It's been delayed so much already that I'm happy to wait another 6 or 7 months. Obviously, this is all happening because of the pandemic, but you know, we are starting to get vaccines in place, places are starting to open up, so I don't really see why Warner Brothers need to rush this out all of a sudden when, you know, the chances are that they'll probably actually be able to hit the release date. However, that depends on a lot of things and infrastructures and places really being COVID secure for when that releases in May. Now, it is of course difficult to predict how things are going to go with that. And $200 million, you know, it seems like quite a low figure, but when you look at the grosses that the films in the franchise have actually made, it is sort of in line with that. Now, according to The Hollywood Reporter, the MonsterVerse movies, which are a cornerstone of Legendary Slate, are big international players, and they make a lot of money in China. Just a third of over King of the Monsters' $386 million global box office came from China's release, and Skull Island also grossed $168 million in the country, which was about 30% of its $567 million gross. Now, with those figures, you do kind of get the idea that $200 million isn't really that out of the ballpark here. Typically, when you're trying to work out how much a movie costs, you take the budget and double it. So $400 million is about how much things would cost altogether, and then they'd start to make money back on that. So going off the previous entries, we have $386 million and $567 million. So not too crazy for the studio to just think, let's not take the risk, let's just secure this money in the bag, let them fight on Netflix or something, or HBO Max. Now, I think one of the biggest worries for the studio that's going to be causing a lot of issues is that even if things are ready for May 21st, that there's going to be a backlog of movies that are all just hitting the theatres at the same time and trying to compete with each other. You've got so many films piling up all at once that it will be difficult for any to really stand out in the middle of the crowd. So, you know, this might be the best thing to do for them. Personally, though, I'm sure you can tell, I really think that this deserves to be seen on the big screen. And out of a lot of the movies that were meant to come out this year, besides Dune, this is probably the one that I was most hyped for. Now, obviously, I will keep you up to date on everything. I'd love to hear your thoughts on it as well, as I'm sure many of you are kind of torn on this subject. You know, this has been delayed so much that it's got to a point where you just want to see it, even if it's on your couch. And there's others out there who are like me and think, you know what, we've waited long enough, I'm happy to wait a bit more just to give this the full treatment that it deserves. Because, you know, this is Godzilla versus Kong. You don't get bigger than that, do you? Anyway, drop them in the comments below, and please also give me a thumbs up if you've enjoyed the video. If you want something else to watch, then definitely check out our Godzilla vs. Kong trailer updates that tied into Wonder Woman last week, and also the plot leaks which discussed some points in the movie. As I said earlier, we're giving away 3 copies of the Marvel Phase 2 box set, and all you have to do to be in with a chance of winning is like the video, make sure you subscribe with notifications on, and drop a comment below. The winner is going to be chosen at random on the 30th of November, so make sure you get involved. Anyway, thanks for watching until the end. I'm sure you've got other stuff to do today, so I'll let you get away. Take care. Peace.